need to drill some precise holes, better than I can do with a standard drill chuck. So I'm gonna need collets, and I just picked up this set at the local flea market. I paid 20 euros for them, together with a arbor I needed. And I don't know how good these are, but for the 20 euros I paid for them, I'm willing to take my first steps into the world of collets. But this is an MT3 holder, and my tailstock is MT2, so I'm going to try and make an MT2 holder. I already roughed out a piece of stock metal, and I'm getting ready to turn it further between centers. I'm using a cordless drill to move the compound. That looks pretty good to me. Let's put in the workpiece and start cutting a taper. That's pretty rough. And we still need to remove some material. I changed to a high-speed bit with a nice radius, hoping that it would give me a good surface finish. But well, it isn't perfect. Switch. There is a bit of a chatter pattern. Although I didn't hear any chatter, it might be an imbalance because of this lathe dog. I think I overshot my mark, so I might need to shorten this the tang later on. But for now, I'm gonna polish it and then test fit it. This is what it looks like after polishing and the first test fitting. I took off a bit too much here, but I think it will be fine. I'm getting close. I think I'm gonna file these parts again and then polish it once more, and then it should be good enough. This is what it looks now, and I'll leave it like this. You can see I cut off some extra in the middle. That's because of a bit of damage that's inside the quill taper. Next I'm gonna turn it around and start working on the threading. Alright, let's measure this thing. Millimeters. And this is 34.9. So I'll have to take off a little over 2 millimeters. Although I'm thinking I might leave this a little thicker than this one, because the well, let's call it a knot, it's pretty loose on there. I have a terrible amount of chatter turning the piece from this end, and I don't know why. The chatter never went away, but locking the cross height did help a bit. Alright, I'm now gonna cut a groove to relieve the threading tool. Yeah, that should do it. I'm just eyeballing this. The groove on the original is deeper than really necessary. According to this thread measuring thingy, this is a 2.0 pitch thread. According to this table, we need a 70, a 35 and a 60, oh sorry, 80 and a 60 gear. I got lucky, the correct gears were already on there, so that's a plus, because I hate changing these things. To illustrate the quality of these Chinese, cheap Chinese lathe, I remember from the last time when I fitted these gears that I needed to grind off a piece of this bracket, otherwise the it wouldn't slide up far enough so the gears could engage. I've installed my best 60 degree pointy bit. I've got a machinist square here with a line on there that I made with the point of the live center, and I use this to set the tool height. I also use it to make sure it's square to the workpiece. I don't have a threading dial, so when I start this I'll have to use the motor in reverse to run it back and forwards. I can't disengage the lead screw from now on. I'm getting close, but the OD is a bit too big, so I will need to use a file to cut it down a bit. I marked the jaw, and as long as I go back to that jaw where the lathe dog engages the jaw, it should be fine. Not there yet, but it's close. Well, that's done. It's just as loose as the other one. Not my best thread ever, but then again, I still can count my threads on one hand. It will have to do. Next I'm gonna chuck it up in the fore jaw and start working on the internal taper. This is how I set up the compound for cutting the taper. I wish I had a better stand, because this one is pretty hard to set up on the center line, but that's what I have, it's what I use. I got it indicated to within a hundredth of a millimeter. The needle is jumping a bit because the surface finish isn't perfect. So next is boring this thing out. Well, drilling first and then boring. I drilled to 18 millimeters. Now I'm ready to start cutting the taper. And this worries me a bit, because I have no idea if I can get a smooth surface finish on that. Well, this is not gonna work. The underside of the tool is rubbing the workpiece. I gotta find some other tool. I just spent a zane amount of time to grind this little tool bit. It's so freaking small, but at least this will fit into the bore. Doesn't sound that good. I spent some more time trying to grind this tool, and I took a cut, and it's my best boring job so far, but the others have been terrible, so. That doesn't say much. Too bad all the chips stay on the inside. I'm really having a hard time cutting this taper. I'm even experiencing some chatter. I think the chips that are tumbling around in there might be damaging the tool bit. I just stoned the edge of the tool, and I'm ready to try again. It sounds terrible. It probably is terrible. Oh, horror. I knew this was gonna be the problem of the hardest part of making this thing. Well, I finally managed to get a reasonable surface finish. Something I can probably polish up. I'm trying to figure out how to determine how far I need to bore this out, and well, measuring this taper is kind of hard because it's also chamfered, so I'm trying to figure out how to do this. The best way I've come up with to determine how far I need to bore this out is to take the original holder, put in a collet, and measure the distance against the front of the holder. So that's 2391. So I'm gonna try and get this as close as possible. Alright, I took another pass. Test fitting. $23.76. So that's still a bit under, but I don't think I can get any closer. So, and polishing it up will get me closer to the original. So now I somehow have to polish up this bore. Alright, this is what I come up with. It's a piece of, what is it? A central heating pipe. I cut a slit in there. And I'm gonna use this to hold this piece of emery cloth. I just did a pass with 180 grit, and this is 540. It's important to polish this bore very smooth, because the collet is gonna slide on that when you tighten the cap. I use a little oil. Keeps most of the swarf in there. And you just try and keep it as parallel as possible to the taper. That looks and feels pretty good. I could probably get it a bit better if I had some finer emery paper, but well, I don't, so this will have to do. $23.85. Well, that's pretty close to the $23.81 I measured with the original, so I'm pretty happy with that. Now I'm gonna cut chamfer on the ID and then I'll put in a collet and do a little measurement, see what kind of run out I got. I cut the chamfer and now it's time for a test. These things are pretty sharp. It should be deburred, I guess. Cap. Oh, hold on. You need to hook it up in the cap and then put it in. Okay. The handle is in the plastic. I'm hoping for, well, 2 hundredths run out or less. That's not right. Hardly any better than my 3-jaw. But it is a little better than my drill chuck. I put it in the other way and I tightened up the nut or cap as much as I could, and now I have about 2 hundredths of a millimeter run out, which is, well, less than 1/1000th of an inch, so I think I should be reasonably happy with this. I don't know how good these collets are. I don't know what kind of specs or runout rating they have, but as my first collet set, and for only, well, less than €20, I should be happy, I guess. Well, that's it.